At the University of Maryland's Human Computer Interaction Lab, design teams meet twice a week at 4 p.m. to devise new technologies for young people. And half the designers are kids, ages 7 through 11.
How much do you need?
2 popsicles, 6, yeah, that's good.
Where there's a clock and it tells you the time of the other place.
The kids are our design partners. We work with them in an equal partnership where they're helping us to design technology for children.
There could be like a place where you could like click on that and then like send in like the money to the website.
So we have a give a gift section.
That's cool. I like that.
They absolutely have as many good ideas as the big people do. The children are experts in being children. And even though we were all children once, we weren't children in 2009. The children oftentimes have ideas that surprise us. They'll open up avenues we hadn't thought about.
We need to make that adjustable so we can see through both of them.
And it's really a process of idea elaboration, where the kids might come out with an idea or an adult comes out with an idea, and we find that working together, we go back and forth and end up with these great big ideas that are much bigger and better than we could have ever made on our own.
What do you think about this keyboard? Can you type an actual sentence on there? What do you think would be ideal for you?
Slide it out.
All right, try this one.
Members of the Kidsteam design group are recruited from local Maryland elementary schools.
Oh, cool.
They help design kid-friendly gadgets and websites for clients that include Fortune 500 companies and nonprofit organizations.
We work with mostly the National Park Service a lot. Some of their games on their website are sort of cheesy, so we are the people who like fix it up and stuff.
Today's challenge is to evaluate and improve upon the website of a nonprofit organization called People in Need.
This is a project about connecting people from here that have resources to people in need in Haiti. How many people know where Haiti is?
But why Haiti?
Why Haiti?
So these are all different people in need in Haiti. And so you can click on one of these families. It says, learn more, help this family. Dana's partnership with Judeline. So I can read you her letter. It says, pleasure is mine to drop you a line.
Does she actually speak in English?
No, she speaks in Creole. I type them and then people in Haiti translate it into Creole.
I thought they didn't have electricity
in
Haiti.
Yeah, they don't have electricity.
And corresponding with her, how you are back and forth like that, that's kind of the way it's set up for you to do it.
Yeah.
After an initial discussion, the brainstorming begins in earnest as the group breaks into small design teams.
All right, go for it.
Nadja and Sasha.
Actually, the favorite technique of all of our children is what the kids call bags of stuff, but the adults call low-tech prototyping.
So should we start to build this thing?
I don't know, Birdie's got something going on.
This is a microphone.
Now, what do we need the microphone for?
You can also do like a video chat.
So a kid might have an idea, and then you may say, yeah, that's a really great idea, but you know, if we make it green, then we could do this, and then I might say, hey, if it's green, polka-dotted, and furry, can you imagine? And we go from there, and you're not sure whose idea it was eventually, but it's amazing.
So we have to present and show.
Oh.
Share. Because everybody wants to see what everybody else built.
There are places where people design partner with children in school. However, we find that in schools, a lot of times kids are predisposed to be a part of that adult-child power dynamic that kind of always exists in a school in American culture for good reason. You know, you have one teacher and 20 students. So when you go into schools, a lot of times you find that that power dynamic will carry over and the kids aren't as free with their ideas.
And when it goes to her, it would be all translated into whatever language they speak.
Ready?
No, yes, sorry. Go on.
Once each of the groups has their low-tech prototypes, we come back together and we take a look at each of the prototypes. Each of the groups presents their ideas.
It's like an iPod. Okay. And press play. Mm-hmm. Right there.
And this is a map of where your partner lives.
Oh, so you want to do it totally on mobile phones?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then the leader will be writing what we call the big ideas. And those big ideas, again, is almost a frequency analysis of the kinds of ideas that are coming out of an existing session. And it's very exciting. We come up with some wonderful design directions.
This is, if you want to make a video to your partner, you can just put the camera on your computer and then you can do the video.
So it was streamlining the
video taking process.
Good work, all right. Okay. Well done, folks. Thank you very much.
For more information about what works in public education, go to edutopia.org.